Morning, YouTubers. Today's video is going to be super topical, I guess like all of my videos. And what I'm going to talk about today, be really brief, is I'm just going to share with you the clasp on this watch. So this is the Cartier ladies tank or small size tank. This is the Tank Solo. You've seen my unboxing video of this recently. I'm posting this video because I noticed in my analytics that a lot of you have enjoyed that video. It's gotten a lot of views, a lot more views than some of the other videos. And I think it tells me something. It tells me that maybe you have an interest in this particular watch or that whatever I said in that video caught your interest. So what I wanted to do is just talk a little bit about the clasp, and then I'll come back when I have more time and I've collected my thoughts, and I'll talk to you about the maybe like a kind of a wearer's review. Now, let me start by saying this is not... I don't really wear this watch. This is my partner's watch, my wife's watch. It won't fit my wrist. It's a sort of a small watch, and it would wear quite well for even my wrist size if I got a bigger strap. So the reason the view is zoomed in so much is because we're going to talk about this clasp. So sorry, forgive my dry skin. So what we're going to talk about is this is a stainless steel model. It's got a quartz movement. If you get the gold model, it comes with a tang buckle, like a typical like pin buckle. If you get the model that's gold and solid gold, it comes with a solid gold pin buckle. If you get the model that's gold case and stainless steel back, it comes with like a smaller, more modest gold pin buckle. You know, typical pin buckle is like a tang, you know, the little pin goes through the strap and the strap has little holes in it. One of the things that's really cool about this stainless steel model is it comes with this really elegant deployant clasp, fold-over deployant clasp. It has the classic Cartier C, as you see right there, Cartier C. And it's all stainless steel and it's well made. It feels artfully crafted. So you'll see here, it's a Swiss made stainless steel Cartier. You can see it has a little lip right there. It works through friction. Has this lovely sculpted stainless steel blade, and you see right there that little hole, that's where the friction, this tooth fits. You see that? Again, sorry for the close-up zoom. It's signed, it's Swiss made, has a solid pin, no folded pins in this one. And you'll notice what's interesting is you see that little pin right there? That's actually a screw. It's threaded. It's the metal feels very smooth and sort of sandblasted or maybe tumbled finish, but it feels very, very well made, sculpted. Over here, you're gonna note that there's another screw. Isn't that kind of impressive for a part that's so small? That's a screw. I think, to me, that this has little screws right here is kind of cool. And this little pin, that's some sort of a pin. It doesn't seem, you know, like if you look right here, you would say, well, how could that pin be a solid pin? Because it goes across, but it doesn't depress like a spring bar. It's like almost like a metal tab. And it fits in this overall buckle sort of like with compression or some sorts. And you see right there, that's the threaded end of the screw on the other side. Sorry for the smudges, it's hard. Okay, and you'll see that this top appears to be a solid piece of metal. Maybe it's been machined or a mixture of machined and welded, brazed, it's hard to say. But you see, you know, the reason I'm doing such a close-up is to show you the construction. So first we're gonna talk about how it closes and unlocks, and then we're gonna talk a little about how you adjust it. Because one of the clever features on this is that it's self-adjusting. So what happens is you see that little, see the little tab? The tab is this, and you see the little orifice, which you see right there? So the tab will just lock into that orifice, and it snaps. And to open it, you just do like that. It's got a very positive closure. You have to work it a few times and open it, close it, to kind of get it broken in, because it's very tight at first. And if you have a very small wrist, you know, when you put this on your wrist and you just press, it can be a little painful. It's easier to get off because you just kind of like use it like a lever action and it pulls it off. This hinging action sort of pulls it out of the little orifice. Okay, so how would you adjust this? You see this strap, you see on the inside? No holes. On the inside, no holes there either. Do you see that? What's so clever and elegant about this strap is that you just, it sort of works like those buckles on like a backpack, those nylon loop buckles. You just push it through and then you would, you know, pull this side down or pull this side out and it would adjust. It's a really elegant, I don't want to change the sizing because it was a bit of a challenge for us jointly to get it sized up for her small wrist, but you see, in a way, the same thing happens on this side. You can sort of push this. You just push it and pull it, slide it through. And it's not really loose to slide it through. There's plenty of friction, but it's a toolless adjust, which is going to be nice because like if we were on vacation or something and I didn't have a tool to adjust it, I could just do it kind of in a way on the fly, like from the, you know, from wherever you are. So this is interesting. So I'll note that like, and I'll zoom the camera out in a minute, like on hers, on this one, we've got this strap tail, you know, about halfway up. So it's probably a third of the full length. And we've got this one tucked in a little bit too. That's because it's actually pretty big on her wrist, even though it's, you know, I'd say it's probably like smaller than 5 inches, maybe 4.5 inch diameter right here. This is really small. So let me zoom out a little bit if I can. Okay. So right now the watch is set to wear very, very small for a small wrist. But I think, you know, if you're like, say, like I have a large watch, I have a large wrist. If I wanted to wear this watch, it would actually look fine. I just need to get a longer strap. In fact, this size, this is the small size. It really looks great on a male's wrist because it has such a tremendous classic elegance. It's like, you know, sort of like it's timeless and it would work really well for a man's wrist. Maybe I'll do a video when I go through and review this. And I'll talk more about, like, you know, maybe getting a bigger strap for it. Like I said, though, I don't want to go on and on and on. The purpose of this video was just to show you this clasp and show you how cool it is and how it can be adjusted on the fly. And just to kind of give you, like, a zoomed-in close-up of what it would be like to have this watch with this clasp. Also in the fact that I believe you can buy this clasp separately with these very thin calfskin straps from Cartier. I would encourage you, if you're interested in this watch and you don't mind buying online, go to the Cartier e-boutique. You don't really get a discount. I think dealers would offer a discount. I bought mine from the Cartier e-boutique. The experience is great. They really customize it for you. You can get all different kinds of straps with this buckle. You can just pick your straps. I think there's about 20 different patterns and textures and colors and materials. You just get what you want, what would work for whoever you're giving it to or yourself. With Valentine's Day coming up, or maybe I'll post this after Valentine's Day, this is just something you could consider. Okay, with that, thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe. I'll post some more videos of this in the near future. Be well.